Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the American Public Transportation Foundation Scholarship Awards presentation, celebrating 30 years. And now, your host, Eva Saha.
Good afternoon, everybody. I am Eva Saha, as the voice of God said, and I'm so honored to be here today to host the 2018 American Public Transportation Foundation Scholarship Award Ceremony. Welcome to Nashville, everybody. I hope you've been having a great time here. So the mission of the American Public Transportation Foundation is to increase and retain the number of individuals choosing the public transportation field as a career by providing scholarships and engagement opportunities to deserving students and transit professionals who will lead our industry into the future. With their continued innovation and focus on building a system that supports the greater Nashville region, which includes Fisk, Vanderbilt, and 16 other colleges and universities, WeGo Transit is a great host for this celebration. Now, today's program is a testament to the value and benefit of supporting scholars and professionals as they achieve their educational goals and make their mark in the transit industry. We have a very esteemed turnout today. We have members of APTA's executive leadership, members of the APTF board, past scholars, general managers, CEOs, business members, and many friends. Today we're going to hear from members of the foundation board who will tell us about their activities and this year's successful fundraising efforts. APTA's president and CEO, Paul Skatelis, will offer his congratulations to the 33 APTF scholarship recipients we are here to honor today. And then finally, the ceremony will be closed out by APTA's chair, David Stackrow. So we look forward to a great program this afternoon. Since its inception in 1988, the APTF has provided over 300 scholarships to former scholars who now serve in leadership roles all across the industry, from operations managers to CEOs. Though we do not have time, unfortunately, to hear from all 300, we're going to see video messages from several past scholars who will share how receiving an APTF scholarship has helped them in their career journey. Their appreciation is a wonderful reminder of how many people we have supported together over the past 30 years and why we continue to do this great work. But first, please assist me in welcoming Paul Skatelis, APTA's president and CEO, who will help kick off today's show. Everybody, how about a big round of applause for Paul?
Thank you, Eva, and hello. You know, just a very short while ago, was it about an hour or so, we left the awards luncheon. And we had the great occasion to recognize all of those who have made great contributions, both this past year as well as in their careers in public transit. And here we kind of flip it around and look to recognize our deserving recipients for scholarship awards. And there's great logic and importance to that because the recipients one day will be great contributors to our industry on a daily basis, and I'm sure many will find their way into the APTA Hall of Fame one day. So today we're recognizing 33 deserving recipients of scholarships that are awarded by the American Public Transportation Foundation, and we're here to celebrate these scholars' commitment to our industry. They represent the next generation of public transportation leaders. To every scholarship winner, congratulations. You join a select group of more than 300 former scholarship winners who have benefited from the foundation's support and are now giving back to our industry. We're eager to hear your personal stories today, and just as importantly, we look forward to the stories you will write as future leaders. APTA and the foundation are making an investment in public transportation's future by, yes, investing in you. As you participate in the annual meeting here in Nashville, think about how you can make a lasting contribution to our industry, and importantly, to the foundation. Think of giving back not only as a duty, but as a privilege and as a reward. The Foundation's gift will help each of you achieve your educational and professional goals. And it does something more. In fact, it provides an opportunity for you to work with experienced, high-caliber mentors who are passionate about how public transportation changes people's lives and changes people's lives for the better. Become that kind of mentor for future APTF scholars. Help ensure that public transit retains and attracts the talented leaders that we will need and require over the next 30 years. Make us proud, and in so doing, honor the Foundation and honor yourselves. And now, let's hear from Hugh Mose, Chair of the Foundation's Board of Directors. Hugh?
Well, first of all, thank you all for coming out today to celebrate our scholars. I want to start out by recognizing APTA Chair David Stackrow and APTA's President and CEO Paul Skatelis, who just spoke, for their commitment to the Foundation. We were especially pleased when Paul was selected to lead APTA, since he is a former member of the Foundation Board and has been a champion of our work for many years, and also, I might add, a tremendous benefactor for the Foundation. I also want to extend the Foundation's gratitude to our immediate past chair, Nat Ford. We have been tremendously fortunate in the past year to work with Nat. He's been a spokesman for the Foundation at every opportunity, and we appreciate his ongoing support. As many of you know, Nat demonstrated his commitment to the Foundation through the support of a terrific fundraising reception at the APTA Annual Meeting and Expo a year ago in Atlanta. It was quite an evening. Nat also encouraged his friends and colleagues inside and outside the industry to donate to the Foundation. Through that great effort, we were able to raise enough money to fund a new named scholarship, which Nat dedicated to his father, Nathaniel Ford. This scholarship was a wonderful recognition of Nat's father's own commitment and years of service through his career at the New York City Transit. The Nathaniel Ford Scholarship will be awarded for the first time today to a scholar who is pursuing a career in public transportation and which will help continue the legacy created by Nat's father and continued by Nat himself. As we begin a new term marked by yesterday's gavel exchange, the Foundation Board looks forward to working with APTA's new chair, David Stackrow, who has already demonstrated his commitment to advancing future leaders in our industry and has been himself a generous supporter of the Foundation throughout the years. The Foundation relies on advocates like our past and our incoming chair to help us spread the word about the Foundation, and this marks our 30th year. As the chair of this board, I follow in the path of the Foundation's first chair, Richard Bouchard. Since his tenure 30 years ago, many great leaders have served on this board, and I'm honored to be included in their number. This year, the board has taken on several exciting initiatives, including the revision of our corporate recognition program and the creation of a mentoring program which we think will ensure that our scholars receive support and guidance beyond just the financial award that comes with the scholarship and the opportunity to attend the annual meeting to receive their award. I would like to personally thank my colleagues on the APTF board for their leadership and their dedication. There are a lot of people who put in a lot of time and energy for no compensation to make sure that the Foundation continues to thrive and increase in its success. Since the inception of the Foundation in 1988, We've benefited from the knowledge and guidance of board made up of industry leaders who are totally committed to supporting and growing the next generation. And they give their time and their energy, and we all try to be the very best stewards that we can. I also want to take a minute and thank the staff, the APTF staff that provides all of the support that's necessary for the foundation to do the work that we do. I can tell you that the board is truly dedicated and works hard, but we couldn't really make anything happen if it wasn't for the APTF staff. And I want to stand here before you and publicly acknowledge them. So, yeah. They are a wonderful crew, and we couldn't do it without them. Anyway, as we bring our 30th year to a close, we do so with a strong foundation, thanks to the dedication and leadership of a generous and passionate board. So please now join me in thanking the board for all of their hard work. Now, I mentioned that board of directors change over the years, and of course, this year is no exception. And so we're pleased that the APTA's executive committee recently approved our chair's recommendations to reappoint current board members. I'm honored to take on one more year as the foundation's chair. Joining me is Ms. Janet Walker Ford, who will serve again as the foundation's vice chair, and Dominic DeBrito, Jesse Oliver, and Raquel Olivier, all dedicated board members, have been reappointed to additional terms. I'm also happy to report that we have two new board members, APTA's immediate past chair, Nathaniel Ford, and Kim Green. Kim has been on the board through his position as former treasurer. Now he will continue on the board in his own capacity, and we are thrilled that he will continue to be an active and dedicated member. Each of these new and appointed board members look forward to helping us as we seek to further the mission of the APTF. But as we recognize the current board members, I also want to take a minute, because it's our 30th anniversary, to thank those who came before and help get us where we are today. 3 decades ago, the initial APTF Board of Directors established the vision to support the future of the foundation. And there are several of those members going way back who are still active in the industry. Joe Alexander, Ron Barnes, and Fred Gillum. I want to especially recognize 2 members of the initial board who have remained committed to the foundation and hold the distinction of being our longest serving board members. Please join me in offering a special thanks not to just those folks I just mentioned, but also Reema Malone and Rick Simonetta. Without their leadership through the years, we would simply not be where we are today. Please join me. You know, as exciting as it is to stand before you, there's also a note of sadness, too, because over the past year, we lost 2 long-term committed members of the foundation family. First of all, Dan Reichard. Dan was an industry leader and a business member who served on the foundation board. He was recognized by his colleagues and APTA's business members with the creation of a named scholarship, which Dan joined us to award just last year in Atlanta. Dan was a friend and a mentor to many in his industry and GenFair, the organization he founded. That organization continues to this day to be a generous supporter and sponsor of the foundation's work. Last year, we also lost Stephanie Pinson. She was a member of the APTF board and a true champion for the foundation. As a member and then chair of the Business Member Board of Governors, she was dedicated as an advocate for the transit industry. This year, the current members of the Business Member Board of Governors recognized her tireless work for the foundation and created a named scholarship designated to recognize a female scholar of high academic achievement who is pursuing a degree in science or engineering. And we're proud today to award that scholarship for the very first time. Finally, I speak on behalf of the entire board when I express my thanks to the individual and corporate donors who have been so generous, not just this year, but past years as well. It's through the generosity that the APTF has now awarded a total of over $1.2 million of scholarship support to more than 300 recipients over the past 30 years. Those donations ensure that our scholars receive the financial assistance for the education they need to become even more talented, more dedicated, and a more diverse workforce. Your donations are an investment in the future of these scholars, the future that they will bring to our industry to become general managers, marketing directors, regional vice presidents, and other leaders in all facets of public transportation. So to our current and our future donors, we thank you for your continued support and your investment in the next generation. I'm pleased to announce that because of that support, this year, the foundation is awarding the greatest number of scholarships we've ever awarded, 33. And the largest dollar amount by far that we've ever been able to award, $205,000. Please, how about a rousing round of applause? Sunday evening, 2 days ago, the foundation had an incredible reception down on Broadway at the Acme Feed and Seed, at which time we honored incoming APTA Chair David Stackrow. At this time, I would like Fran Hooper, who chairs the foundation's fundraising committee and is herself just an incredible fundraiser, to come on stage and talk a little bit more about this very successful event.
APTF is extremely important to get our, you know, to the young folks who are in school right now to even know what public transportation is about. You know, there's a lot of paths that they can go down, and a lot of them don't even know about this wonderful industry with people who are really passionate and excited about moving people and getting people where they need to go. So APTF is that. It is getting young folks engaged and involved in this industry right when they're coming out of school. And you know, what you're doing is helping us invest in the future of public transportation.
Receiving a scholarship is such a motivator for somebody who is new to the industry or has been in the industry for a long time. When you have a scholarship, you know that somebody's behind you and is supporting you to do great in this career. I happen to love working in transportation, and I think that APTF really did me a solid by supporting me.
Isn't it wonderful to hear their stories? It's really wonderful. How many of you were at the foundation reception on Sunday evening? Some of you there? Yeah? We had a wonderful, wonderful time. It was a great evening meeting our new scholars and meeting our transit industry friends. And I want to thank everyone who was there to support the reception. As the chair of the fundraising committee, I'm really, really, really enjoying working with APTA's business members, encouraging them to be sponsors for the reception. The wonderful reception was made possible by many corporate sponsors and to individual contributors who contributed to our 2018 scholars and who raised the money to ensure that the foundation will continue to provide scholarships in the future years. The reception would not have been possible without the generous support of our corporate sponsors. And I do want to recognize them at this point in time. It should be on the screen. Cubic Transportation Systems, New Flyer of America and Motor Coach Industries, Systra Engineering, HNTB, WSP, Balfour Beatty, STV, RATP Dev, Nova Bus and Prevost, Parsons Corporation, Alstom, AECOM, CRRC, Genfair, and Transdev North America. Our silver level sponsors who contributed $2,500 or more are the Business Member Activity Fund, Gillig, Clever Devices, Proterra, Bombardier, HDR, and the Capital District Transportation Authority in Albany. I think that's probably about the first transit agency that's helped support the reception. And our bronze sponsors were the ones who donated for $1,000 or more, were Footprints, ERA Contact, First Transit, Greystone Management Solutions, Init Innovations in Transportation, and Legacy Research Group. We were also very fortunate to get some silver special individuals providing early support for the event for the reception. We want to thank Michael and Cynthia Scanlon, Hugh and Janice Mose, Pam Boswell, Nat Ford, and Paul Skatelis. I shouldn't have even messed that one up. Anyway, because of all this work and all these the sponsors that we've had and donations, I am totally thrilled to tell you that we have raised $225,000 for the Scholarship Foundation. Another successful program that the foundation has launched this year is our single-year scholarship campaign. The single-year scholarships are unique because they don't require an endowment, and they're created and awarded in the same year. This new program has been established for individuals and organizations that want to offer a scholarship but don't have the budget to meet the $1,000, $100,000 commitment for a required for a named scholarship. This year, we're really pleased to have three single-year scholarships, which illustrate the broad base of support for the foundation. The KFH Group, whose single-year scholarship is supporting an individual who has been working in the transit industry. The KFH Group is based in Bethesda, Maryland, and has been a long-time supporter of the foundation. This is the second year that the Mineta Transportation Institute has partnered with the foundation to offer the Mineta APTA Joint Scholarship. This scholarship supports a current Mineta Institute student and reflects the foundation's commitment to support institutions that have exemplary transportation programs that feed our workforce pipeline. Devin Roy received a scholarship foundation scholarship last year and is employed with Olivier Incorporated. Appreciating the scholarship that he got last year, Devin wanted to give back to the industry, and he raised $5,000 to create the Roy Scholar Ambassador Program. I have to say that the people who work in the public transit industry are very, very generous, and they also recognize that the future of our industry depends upon talent, new talent, and young people. So may we thank all those organizations and individuals who supported the foundation and who will sustain the foundation for 30 more years.
The foundation is wonderful. They are really encouraging of young professionals and to stay within the industry, and they are all about promoting you and giving you opportunities that you didn't really know that you had. So for me, the foundation has been nothing but encouraging to, one, advance my education, but also advance my career. They are very much into keeping you within the industry. I myself would love to stay within the foundation and participate as much as I possibly can. And I plan to do that as I move forward in my career.
Thank you so much for that, Fran and Paul and Hugh. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time to hear from one of our scholars. As part of the incredibly competitive selection process, our scholars must submit a comprehensive application, as you all know, which includes an essay explaining why they chose a career in public transportation. Each year, the APTF board recognizes an essay that stands out above the others to receive the Donald C. Hyde Memorial Scholarship. We cannot, of course, let the celebration go by without letting you hear an excerpt from our winning essay. So we are so pleased at this time to honor Abubakar Zidane, this year's winner of Best Essay, entitled Transit Data. How about a big round of applause for Abubakar Zidane?
Thank you, Ms. Zaha. Growing up as a frequent transit user influenced my perspective on transportation. For me, transit is not just a mode of transport. Transit is a way of life, a way that teaches diverse users with different origins and backgrounds that they can work together if they have the same destination. Transit for me is a great chance to listen to different life stories that will directly affect the way I think about things and gain real-life experiences. Transit is a small picture of life, where a group of people will choose to ride the bus or the train because they know that is the optimal choice for them and the community. More transit usage is the win-win situation for transit users, transit agencies, communities, and even automobile users, since it's more economical, environmentally friendly, and reduces congestion. In my view, I see transit as the future and the career that I have chosen to serve my community. I have worked in the transit industry as a transportation planner in both in the USA and Sudan for about 3 years. These two experiences were very different from each other. In Sudan, I work as a transportation planner at Khartoum State Public Transport Authority, working on different projects, like Khartoum Suburban Railway Project and Khartoum Bus Stop Project. The challenge was offering adequate transit capacity that accommodated the increased demand on transit with limited resources. While working as transportation system planner intern at Chattanooga Area Regional Transportation Authority, CARTA, the challenge was different. In a mid-sized city with an acceptable level of congestion and low parking prices, the challenge was how to offer the best service that attracts more transit users. Although these two experiences were different from each other, the common thing between them is that there are always challenges associated with data. These challenges include a general lack of data, the quality of the data, integration of data from different sources, and tools to analyze and communicate information from this data. Data is a game changer for post-transit users and authorities. If the transit user has the exact information he needs in the times he needs, he will be able to optimize his trip, make better decisions, reduces his waiting time, and ultimately be happy with the service provided. On the other side, if the transit agencies know who their users are, their travel patterns, and travel behavior, they will be able to provide better services for their users and communicate better with them. Transit agencies collect different data about their system, such as automatic vehicle location, AVL, automatic passenger counts, ABCs, and many other types of data to evaluate their system, enhance their performance, and more recently, to provide real-time information to their users. Providing real-time information through different mobile applications is a key trend in the transit industry, which can reduce travel time and link users to a mix of transportation services. Together, these data sources can serve both transit agencies and travelers. I have always been passionate about data and how to use data to optimize decision-making process in a transit agency. For the last year, I have been working with CARTA, the Chattanooga Area Regional Transportation Authority, using different data sources, including AVL, ABCs, census data, and real-time information to better understand public transport trends in Chattanooga. These sources can tell many stories about people's movement and their transportation choices. Relocating bus stop might be considered a very small change, but looking at the data, it can be noticed that this small change might have high impacts on people's travel choices, especially if they have to walk longer distances, which will affect the transit ridership. Recent innovations in transportation technology, such as microtransit, mobility on demand, mobile ticketing, and real-time information, have significantly changed the way people plan and conduct their transit trips. Also, there's other critical changes in transportation industry, including the rise of transportation network companies, TNCs like Uber and Lyft, and now the autonomous and connected vehicles. So all these factors contribute to potential change in transit ridership and raises questions concerning the future of public transportation. It's through data analysis. That transit agencies may better understand these issues and guide the decision making. By continuing my education and gain new skills, I believe that I will be able to contribute to the industry and help transit agencies to make better decisions. As I'm working on my PhD in transportation engineering at the University of Tennessee, I'm planning to continue to work with transit data to find answers to these emerging questions about the future of transportation and the impact of technological change on transit. At the University of Tennessee, I'm working with Dr. Candice Breakwood, who did a tremendous amount of research about transit data and factors that affect transit ridership. Working with Dr. Breakwood will offer me the guidance I need to find answers to these questions, as well as many other arising questions in the transit industry. Every day, more data is generated and available for transit providers, and there will be a strong need for researchers to manage this important resource. This transit data field is where I'm planning to spend the rest of my career. Thank you.
For those of you who aren't familiar with the APTF, if you just take a minute to look at the caliber and the wide range of scholars that the foundation has supported over the years, it really goes a long way to show that this investment is really in the future of public transportation. For me, on a personal level, it's impacted my studies and my career trajectory in a way that I can't really explain in words. So if you're gonna donate to this foundation, I definitely say that the money that you spend on this is an investment, and it's in the future of transportation, it's in the future of the industry, and the people that you're going to support, it's going to change their lives for the better. It certainly has mine, and the benefits are far-reaching and really, really heartfelt.
So I think that we can all agree that Abu Bakr's essay was truly inspirational, and it highlights the need for data and effective planning, something that's often overlooked. So we really appreciate your insights, Abu Bakr. And now, yeah, let's give him another round of applause. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to present the 2018 APTF scholarship recipients. The following individuals are receiving named scholarships. Matthew Cahill. Matthew is the recipient of the Jack R. Gilstrap Scholarship and is sponsored by WSP. Now, unfortunately, Matthew was unable to join us today due to a conflict in his class schedule, one of the reasons he's getting the scholarship. So why don't we go ahead and give him a round of applause anyway. Lindsay Ann Cullen. Lindsay is the recipient of the Parsons Brinckerhoff Jim Lammy Scholarship and is sponsored by VHB. Since childhood, Lindsay has used public transportation to travel for work and leisure. She's always admired how well the various aspects of transportation work together to help people get to their destination, and she looks forward to contributing to that. Well, we look forward to seeing your future, Lindsay Ann. It's picture time. Congratulations. Edith Tapia. Edith is the recipient of the Lewis T. Clouder Scholarship, and is sponsored by Raul V. Bravo and Associates, where she works as a project manager. Receiving this scholarship reinforces Edith's commitment to public transportation and motivates her to never stop. She looks forward to helping make public transportation more attractive and accessible to current and future passengers and workers. A lofty goal. Thank you so much, Edith. Congratulations. Julie Tim. Julie is the recipient of the Dan M. Riker Jr. Scholarship and is sponsored by WeGo Public Transit right here in Nashville, where she serves as their chief development officer. Julie believes that we each have a social obligation to work towards positive changes in our lives and in our communities. Working in the public transportation industry allows Julie to support and advance projects and initiatives that can quite literally transform a person's life by giving them mobility and choices on how they live. So true, Julie. Congratulations. Michael Bernhardt. Michael is the recipient of the Dr. George M. Smirk Scholarship and is sponsored by the Central Pennsylvania Transportation Authority, also known as Rabbit Transit, where he is their Director of Mobility Services. Public transportation has been a new challenge for Michael, and it has offered him an opportunity to assist his community through the expansion of traditional ridership while also helping underserved consumers. Well, I know that they appreciate you. Congratulations. Chris Chang. Chris is the recipient of the Richard J. Bouchard AECOM Scholarship and is sponsored by WSP USA. Chris believes that transit has the potential to achieve sustainability and efficiency in intra-city travel and can greatly shape the land use pattern of cities. His degree will allow him to explore the most up-and-coming technologies in transit planning. Well, we look forward to seeing you explore those things. Thank you so much, Chris. Nicholas Atkins. Nicholas is the recipient of the Florida Public Transportation Association Scholarship and is sponsored by the Central Florida Regional Transportation Authority, or LINX, where he is a mobility service representative. Nicholas chose public transportation because of the role it plays in the growth and prosperity of a modern city. Nicholas has a long history with public transit and knows firsthand how well-planned transit systems can make all the difference in the lives of citizens. And we know that you are also making a big difference, so thank you, Nicholas. Justin Sherrill. Justin is the recipient of the Reba Malone Scholarship and is sponsored by King County Metro in Seattle, and is working towards his master's in urban and regional planning at Portland State University. Justin chose a career path in public transportation because the work involved feels essential and is challenging in ways that keep him always hungry for new ideas and methods. Well, we can't wait to see you put them in place, so congratulations, Justin. Jordan Golombeski. Jordan is the recipient of the Raymond C. Miller Scholarship and is sponsored by the Capital Metropolitan Transportation Authority in Austin, Texas, where he works as a creative communication specialist. Receiving this scholarship will allow Jordan to continue his education while focusing on his full-time career at Capital Metro. He plans to use the skills and experience gained in the classroom to better himself so that he can better serve the Austin community. Well, we applaud all of your hard work. Congratulations, Jordan. Hugh has the best clap. I don't know how you do it, but it's really good. We're going to take lessons afterwards. Kadada Malloy. Kadada is the recipient of the Shirley A. DeLibero Scholarship and is sponsored by the LA County Metropolitan Transportation Authority. She's working towards her master's degree in urban planning at UCLA. Go Bruins, I have a daughter there. As a lifelong resident of Los Angeles, Kadada has never owned a car. Through her experience as a transit rider, she became passionate about increasing access to public transportation by enhancing mobility access, job growth, and community relations. Well, that's quite a feat, not ever taking a car to work, and so congratulations, and we wish you all the success. Cassie Hall. Cassie is the recipient of the William Millar Scholarship and is sponsored by the Shared Use Mobility Center in Los Angeles, where she serves as their manager for special projects. And unfortunately, she was so busy with that job, she couldn't make it today. But Cassie chose a path studying and planning public transportation because it brings together her passion for people, cities, and sustainability. Cassie seeks to understand and address inequalities in public transportation to help cities and urban residents thrive. And I'm sure she is doing just that. So we applaud her all the same. Tariq Usman Syed. Tariq is the recipient of the Jerome C. Primo Scholarship and is sponsored by City Bus of Lafayette, Indiana. This is Tariq's second time receiving an APTF scholarship, quite a feat. Being a scholar introduced Tariq to a wonderful community of professionals in the public transportation industry all across the globe. It's also opened new avenues in his career path. Well, congratulations again, Tariq. You must be doing great work. Josie Willman. Josie is the recipient of the BMBG Janie Wolken Memorial Scholarship and is sponsored by the Milwaukee County Transit System. Josie believes that public transit modes are the true veins of every city. They move the necessary pieces to keep the heart of the city pumping and the rest of the surrounding areas connected and alive. Josie will use the scholarship to become the best transit planner she can be. Well, we have no doubt about that. So congratulations, Josie. I love that analogy too. I think we can all identify with that. Bima Dahal. Bima is the recipient of the Fran Hooper Scholarship and is sponsored by the Idaho Transportation Department. Bima believes the field of railroad engineering needs more professionals who dedicate their career to its betterment, and she wants to contribute towards the design, construction, and maintenance of current infrastructure and to conceptualize ways to improve current and future rail projects. That is definitely a lofty goal, and we look forward to seeing all that you achieve. Congratulations, Bima. Darwin Brown. Darwin is the recipient of the Americans with Disabilities Act 25th Anniversary Scholarship and is sponsored by Access Services in El Monte, California, where he serves as a road safety inspector. Receiving this scholarship will help Darwin continue his education so he can take a leadership role in promoting transportation safety and to give back to his community. Well, we know that your community thanks you. Congratulations, Darwin. Congratulations. Matthew Schumacher. Matthew is the recipient of the Bombardier Scholarship and is sponsored by HDR. Matthew is interested in solving issues with congestion and traffic in U.S. cities to make them more enjoyable to live and work. He's also interested in updating and expanding metro and suburban rail systems to help bolster cities. Well, I look forward to you also helping congestion and traffic into Bolster City. So congratulations, Matthew. I think we all do. Sichong Wang. Sichong is the recipient of the Valerie J. McCall Scholarship and is sponsored by the National Transit Institute at Rutgers, where he is a PhD student in transportation planning and policy. Sichong believes that new technologies and modes of transportation are transforming people's travel patterns and challenging the industry. As a transportation researcher, he wants to find ways to provide more efficient, sustainable, and equal facilities to people. Well, we look really forward to seeing your work. Thank you, Sichong, and congratulations. Jared Bendafala. Jared is the recipient of the James Jim Cowan Scholarship and is sponsored by Foothill Transit in West Covina, California. Jared is pursuing his master's in transportation planning from the University of Southern California and chose a career path in public transportation because of his desire to help fight climate change through the reduction of greenhouse gas emissions from the transportation sector. I think that's a goal for all of us. So congratulations, Jared, and keep up the great work. Jody Bees. I think that Jody also could not be with us today, but I'm just going to tell you a little bit about her. Jody is the 2018 recipient of the Frank J. Lachansky Memorial Scholarship and serves as the transit director for Kootenai County in Coeur d'Alene, Idaho. The Lachansky Scholarship is awarded each year to a transit professional from a small or mid-sized agency. The scholarship allowed Jody to attend the Eno Transit Executive Program in Washington, D.C. She's proud to work in the industry that is filled with bright, kind, wonderful people who truly are eager to answer questions and share their knowledge. She hopes to strengthen her effectiveness as a leader and become a greater resource for others who share her same passion for the industry. Well, thank you, Jody. We appreciate you as well. Anybody who knows Jody, let her know. Crystal Bailey. Crystal is the first recipient of the Nathaniel Ford Scholarship and is sponsored by the Kansas City Area Transportation Authority, where she serves as a staff accountant. Crystal chose to make a career in transit because of the important role public transportation plays in people's lives by connecting them with opportunities. Well, that is for certain, Crystal. Congratulations. We're gonna pause to take a couple pictures. There's a lot of love going up on the stage right now, right? Yeah. Why don't we give them a big round of applause? Oh, we got a stalker up here. No, you're paparazzi, right? We got a little paparazzi. Anybody who else wants to be paparazzi, please feel free. Congratulations again, Crystal. We know you're gonna do great work. I hope everyone's got great plans for today in Nashville. Anything fun going on? Is the rain gonna stop? We hope so. Maybe. Taylor Laurent. Taylor is the first recipient of the Stephanie Pinson Scholarship and is sponsored by HDR. Taylor chose a career in public transportation because of the industry's unique focus on building connections between both locations and people, which weave together a stronger, more unified community. This is Taylor's second APTF scholarship, and receiving her scholarship last year provided her with the opportunity to develop her passion and understanding of engineering and transportation. Well, keep up the good work, Taylor. We're very proud of you. Congratulations. Okay, so the following individuals are receiving APTF board scholarships. Daniel Gunlock. Daniel is sponsored by the University of Montana, where he is pursuing his degree in community and environmental planning. Daniel believes that public transportation is the most cost-effective solution for moving people around, especially in urban areas. He's excited to be a part of the growing field and to participate in the planning process. You are so right, Daniel. Congratulations on receiving this honor. Harmony Lloyd. Harmony is sponsored by the Flint Mass Transportation Authority, where she serves as the Director of Planning, Innovation, and External Affairs. Harmony would like to be part of developing the solution to removing barriers to transportation and to assist the residents of Flint in having access to a transit system that is efficient, affordable, and responsive to the needs of the community. Everything that we need in a transportation system. So thank you so much, Harmony. Congratulations. Good job. Joanne Cravens. Joe is sponsored by Ben Franklin Transit in Kennewick, Washington, where she serves as a coach operator. Joe is pursuing her degree in public safety and emergency management from Grand Canyon University. Working in public transportation gives Joe the opportunity to learn about diverse cultures and interesting people. She gets a sense of pride and satisfaction knowing that her job makes people's lives easier. Well, and I know that they all appreciate you. Congratulations, Joanne. Merrick Allen. Now, Merrick is not able to join us today, but he is sponsored by the Southeastern Pennsylvania Transportation Authority in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, where he serves as an assistant director. Merrick chose public transit because it is the lifeblood of the community. I think we can all agree. Good job, Merrick. So we have a lot of busy people here. Matthew DeBona, he's also unable to join us today, but he is sponsored by the Southwest Ohio Regional Transit Authority in Cincinnati, Ohio. Now, receiving this scholarship will allow Matthew to be more engaged with a local bus coalition in the city of Cincinnati. Well, Cincinnati thanks you. Talia Reyes. Talia is another scholar who was unable to join us today due to conflicts with classes. She's sponsored by Metro Transit in Minneapolis-St. Paul and believes that our society must respond to the challenge of climate change while also promoting economic mobility and prosperity for all. So true, Talia, and we congratulate her again. Taj McNair. Taj is sponsored by the Delaware Transit Corporation, where he is a service supervisor. Taj is pursuing his degree in organizational management from Wilmington University and always saw himself playing a major role in public transportation. Well, we know you are on your way there, so we really applaud you, Taj. Congratulations. Good job. Zachary Mallett. Zachary is sponsored by the San Francisco Bay Area Rapid Transit and is pursuing his PhD in urban planning and development from the University of Southern California. As a transit-dependent youth, Zachary found intrigue observing and analyzing what made public transportation a competitive travel mode in some environments, but not in others. This early exposure to public transportation set the foundation for his career in transportation planning. We look forward to seeing all that you do. Congratulations, Zachary. Congrats. So the foundation is proud to offer single-year scholarships to the following scholars. Cameron Simons. Cameron is a recipient of the Mineta Transportation Institute American Public Transportation Foundation Joint Scholarship and is sponsored by the Mineta Transportation Institute at San Jose State University. Cameron is pursuing his master's in statistics and plans to use his data analytics skills to focus on urban issues such as housing and transportation. Great job, Cameron. Keep up the good work. Leonardo Fewell. Leonardo is the recipient of the KFH Group Incorporated Scholarship and is sponsored by the San Diego Metropolitan Transit System, where he works as a regulatory enforcement supervisor. Now, though Leonardo is unable to join us today, accepting the scholarship on his behalf is Sunap, president of KFH Group. Thank you for being here, and congratulations to Leonardo. Jessica Villanos. Jessica is the recipient of the Devin Roy APTF Scholar Ambassador Program Scholarship. Jessica is sponsored by Access Services, where she serves as an operations supervisor. Jessica received a scholarship in 2017 and feels that the APTF has encouraged her professional growth within the transportation industry, and she looks forward to sharing those lessons and giving back within and outside her network. We look forward to that, Jessica. Congratulations again. Keep up all the great work. Yes, feel free to shout loudly for the winners. Finally, we have the recipient of this year's Donald C. Hyde Memorial Essay Award, who we already met, Abubakar Zidan. Abubakar is sponsored by the Prova Group in Chattanooga, Tennessee. Abubakar sees transit as the future, More transit usage is the win-win situation for transit users, transit agencies, communities, and even automobile users, since it's more economical, environmentally friendly, and it reduces congestion. Those are all true. We really loved hearing your essay. Congratulations, Abu Bakr. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in congratulating once again the 2018 American Public Transportation Foundation scholarship recipients. They're all so deserving, and you are all our great hope for the future. And thank you, Hugh. You did a great clapping and great smiling for those pictures. And now I would like to invite David Stackrow, APTA's new chair, to close out today's show. Let's give him a warm welcome, everybody.
Thank you, Eva, and most importantly, thank you to Hugh and the Foundation Board for investing in the next generation of our leaders. I want to recognize the tremendous support we saw at Sunday evening's fundraising event. I'm especially grateful to the sponsors who really helped make it such a success. Thank you all for joining us and for your generous contributions. But it's not all about being able to write a check. It's about being able to impact someone's life who is passionate about what public transportation can do. As a personal supporter of the foundation, I'm proud to stand here today and honor this year's scholars. What we see represented in this year's scholarship recipients are diverse specializations that are essential to public transit's future workforce. Many of this year's scholars are already working in the industry. They are serving as coach operators, communication specialists, operations supervisors, project managers, and yes, my personal favorite, accountants. I am a CPA. The foundation is doing what great organizations do. It's creating a legacy and inspiring others to learn, to lead, and to give. Through giving, as we did on Sunday night, we are attracting a new talent and setting high standards for our industry. Giving binds us together and encourages all of us to ask, what are we doing for public transportation's future, and what are we doing for each other? As APTA chair, I will continue my personal commitment to the great foundation and champion its work and the people that it serves. Thank you all for joining us today to recognize our scholars and for celebrating the American Public Transportation Foundation's 30 years of investing in the next generation of transit leaders. Friends and colleagues, please join me in another round of applause for our scholars and their sponsors. And I thank you, and please enjoy the rest of the annual conference.